Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Vladimir, I am a web developer. Today we will discuss one of the most important and relevant topics for everyone who wants to enter IT, finding a job as a programmer. This is a very relevant topic for many. In recent years, the IT field has been developing rapidly. High salaries, working from home, and interesting tasks attract more and more people. But there is another side to the coin, finding a job as a programmer. Today we will talk about why it has become difficult and how to ease this path. Who hasn't subscribed? Subscribe, and I hope this video will be useful, since I will share my experience and opinion in finding a job as a programmer. Nowadays, finding a job as a programmer is difficult not only for beginners, but also for experienced specialists. Many comments and discussions confirm this. Let's figure out why this is happening. The first and crucial point is education. If you are studying at a university, you have the opportunity to gain deep knowledge and a foundation for future work. Now, what I would like to note about the courses. Courses that promise to make your programmer into weeks are a myth. Good courses take from 3 to 6 months, and this time is enough to gain basic knowledge and skills. From my experience, I can say that employers pay more attention to my degree rather than courses. Although I also took courses and they gave me new knowledge and saved time if I had looked for information on my own. Thus, the university and the courses together provide a good foundation for IT. At university you gain general IT knowledge, while courses provide knowledge in a specific narrow direction. I return to courses later and talk about their benefits. There are also platforms where you can learn programming, where you can first learn in theory and then consolidate theoretical knowledge in practice. In the following videos, I will tell you more about this platform. The second point is the popularity of directions. Many people are looking to get into web development, creating huge competition. They look only at the popularity of programming languages, forgetting about other areas. Look at other areas such as databases development, system administration, testing, and so on. These areas may be less competitive and in demand, making it easier to find a job. The third point is a resume. It should be professionally designed and structured, starting from the photo to your experience, education, and skills. Pay special attention to this. A good resume is your first step to an interview. I am not talking about experienced programmers. As a beginner programmer, you have the same conditions as others. You are applying, like everyone else, for the position of a beginner programmer. Therefore, if you receive only rejections, something might be wrong with your resume. You can also write to the company and ask why you were rejected. Some companies will answer that another candidate is more suitable in terms of skills, but there are companies that will explain the real reason for the refusal. The fourth point is the size of the company. Try to apply not only to large companies, but also to medium and small ones. Large companies have many selection stages, which takes time and creates difficulties. In small companies, you can get a job faster since the hiring process is quicker and the requirements are lower. The fifth point is remote work. Companies can look for employees worldwide, increasing competition. Accordingly, finding a job becomes more difficult. But if you have the choice to work in an office or remotely, I would recommend starting in an office if you are beginning my programming career. It will speed up your learning and help you integrate into the team faster. I want to return to the question of programming courses. There are courses that provide a really good foundation and are well structured, but they don't help with employment. Their goal is to teach you programming. But there are courses that guarantee employment because they cooperate with companies and these companies are interested in specialists from these courses. Let's summarize. Finding a job as a programmer is a long path requiring patience and perseverance. Send resumes. Work on your mistakes, work on your projects and don't give up. This will definitely bear fruit. If the video was helpful, like, subscribe to the channel and share your experience in the comments. In the next video, I talk about how to write a resume correctly and how to search for a job as a programmer. See you in the next video. Bye.